What's up, guys? This is the Dorky Duo. I'm Gavin.
And I'm Rachel.
And we're playing a new game called the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe. I'm not sure what it is. I got some weird office noise in the background.
Office background noise.
Not the good kind of office, you know. Just like the office.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427.
427.
Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on the keyboard.
I can press
orders came to him through a monitor.
He's like doing one finger at a time.
Telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order.
Bro, what's the point?
This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job.
No.
Stanley was happy.
He's lying.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened. This complete isolation. Something
afraid.
Was very clearly wrong.
Zombies?
Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
That's cool. Bro, his whole life is this.
Oh my goodness, it's not even cute in here. What's that say? I hate Mondays.
That's funny.
Okay. Dang.
It's kind of like what my life is. Just a computer and a desk.
No.
It's super boring. You just stare at paperwork.
No. You get to go outside. You drive cars. You're being such a wiener.
It's super hard doing what I do, Rachel.
Why don't we leave the office?
I'm playing. Okay, so that does that. That's crouch. Ain't about a home.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Oh, yeah.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
It's weird that everything is numbered like this.
Yeah.
We're all just
I wonder what number I would be.
69.
I like work, I just
hate my boss.
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story in any way.
That's hilarious, I really like this. What does that say? Have fallen.
Now the money? You keep moving. Now the money have fallen?
Mm-hmm. Are these clues?
Dang, yeah. What's up with all the paper on the floor?
Knowing your city.
Hmm.
What happened? Looks like people are in a rush. This can't be good. Where's the meeting room at?
So far, I haven't seen anything that stood out to look like a meeting room. That's a ladder. Click, click.
Click.
That looks like a meeting room, but...
I don't want the lighting in there.
But the door's locked, so I guess that's not it.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
What if we didn't go to the left?
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly.
Are we gonna die? Oh.
Well.
Wait, what are you doing?
It's taking control.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire.
This game is now paused. I didn't do anything.
Admire it.
The game is having a mind of its own.
What do you mean?
Unless the controller she's messing up. That was weird. It isn't like that. I went against the grain.
Yeah, well, I thought you were telling me the game was controlling the character. And then I was like, okay, well, let's see what happens. But you kept pausing it.
It started pausing itself.
Yes,
truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Should be?
Yeah.
What's down here, though?
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Do not lie. You're lying right now. Stop.
I feel scared.
Yeah, it's like God's telling us to do something and we're disobedient. I kind of regret my choice.
Oh no, what happened?
I don't know. What's happening?
But Stanley simply couldn't handle the pressure.
What pressure?
If he had to make a decision? What if a crucial outcome fell under his responsibility? He had never been trained for that. No. This couldn't go any way except badly.
Backwards.
The thing to do now, Stanley thought to himself, is to wait. Nothing will hurt me. Nothing will break me. In here, I can be happy forever. I will be happy. Stanley waited. Hours passed. Then days.
Let me have.
Had years gone by? He no longer had the ability to tell. But the one thing he knew for sure, beyond any doubt, was that if he waited long enough, the answers would come. Eventually, someday, they would arrive.
Oh my goodness.
Soon. Very soon now, this will end. He will be spoken to. He will be told what to do. Now it's just a little bit closer.
Bro.
Now it's even closer.
Come on.
Just
here it comes.
Oh no!
We die? This is so weird.
I hope we're doing this right. I feel like we're screwing up.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room.
Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
This time, let's follow the directions, please.
Fine. I'll be obedient.
Okay.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Because he has to be told what to do, so he just does it? This game's weird, bro.
Spooky. Ugh, it's solid white.
Yeah, I don't like that.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
What to do about 432?
Is that us?
Yeah.
Don't
tell 42 about the meeting.
Do they not like him?
Is it because he smells? Preview. What? Group
okay.
46. There's X's too. It's like.
Well, that could just be random numbers and not. You know how like you put an X if there's like a.
We're broke Wednesday.
Yeah, I saw that.
Financial panic meeting. Boss's inspection. Oh gosh. Mergers.
Cranking floor 5. I like that.
Ideas and development.
That is so bizarre. What to do about 432? Like, why?
Don't tell him about meeting. Yeah, that is weird.
Okay. Okay. Weird.
Cabal? Group, that's weird.
Look at that one.
This is weird.
Targets. Push for funding for R+D. Get Chris out of the broom closet. Hire someone to synergize papers. Papers are to synergize paper. Fire the paper guy. Hire somebody to fire the paper extension guy.
That's hilarious. Who moved my desk? Please keep the targets on topic of the future was yesterday. Tomorrow is now. Tomorrow. Complete today's unfinished agenda ideas. Items. Write next day's agenda. Reflect. Gosh.
Oh, the slides are moving.
How to solve a dispute with a coworker.
Oh.
Let it blow up inside of you. Take out your passive aggressive and other coworkers. Resent coworkers for not supporting you more.
What?
Using slides to assure employees that everything is okay. Make sure your slide has a sleek blue graphic in the header. And throw some bevel on all the text. This will ensure a calm and productive
environment.
Everyone is unique. You most of all.
Oh. I thought I was saying most of y'all.
Synergize core value. Shift global market. Okay. This is funny.
All right. Lot of percent.
A lot of percent. So I wasn't invited to this meeting. You guys all suck.
It feels like a prank, but...
That's a deadly prank.
Dude, that door was that door locked?
They're coming to a staircase, me,
Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Whoa, there.
It looks like a hotel.
Yeah, fancy. Executive bathroom.
Fun. Ah!
Because the boss knows that the boss says goes, if the boss has suffered losses, then that's what the boss chose. What kind of magazine you got? Extreme bathrooms.
Read about bathrooms while you're in the bathroom.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I like the red and brown scheme.
Yeah.
But it's, even though it's pretty, it's
kind of creepy.
Spooky, yeah. The beige pages. Ooh.
A panda.
No, I don't like it.
Do I hold a gun to its head? Business strategy. That is hilarious. What do we do?
I can't believe it works for these guys.
Yeah.
You have a thing now. Wait, you might not be going the right way.
That's right.
Oh.
Look, world domination or something?
The most something. This is the office we're supposed to go into.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life.
A code.
Shocked,
yeah.
Unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him.
Okay.
And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845.
Oh, bro.
Thanks, man.
But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
Well.
Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened
to input
the correct code.
I thought we were going to have to go find it out.
He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Whoa. This is creepy. I don't like this.
You know what this reminds me of? That movie we watched?
That girl that got, like, in that apartment complex.
Yeah, the Airbnb.
And then they, like, they hammer her hands into the wall.
No, that's not what I was thinking of.
No, what was that one movie where she goes...
I was talking about The Barbarian.
Oh, The Barbarian. No.
Yeah, because the secret, you know, they go into another room.
Okay,
and then the concrete...
What's that other horror movie where the girl...
Yes, I know what you're thinking of. That was a room, like, something. You know, it had an apartment number.
Yeah, that's what that... This is, reminds me. I need a flashlight.
Or it's... No, it's called... It just had the three digits. Because the name of the door was the name of the title.
Oh. Can I fall to my death?
I don't like it. No.
I guess I got no choice.
I guess. Maybe there's a floor.
Oh, there is. Oh.
Ah!
Oh, this is creepy, bro. I pressed up. What are we going down?
Spooky.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar.
Uh-oh.
It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself.
This is like an NPC,
to question
right?
the nature
the
of his job.
Yeah.
Why did he feel
He's
this
like, what
now,
do I do?
When for years
yeah.
it had never
it's
occurred
like,
to him?
It's like a free guy.
This question would not go unanswered
out of their
for
character.
Long.
Whoa.
Do you remember that movie with Will Ferrell, the author's talking about his life? A strange series of unfortunate.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large
mind
door.
Control.
Red mind control.
Escape. What the heck? I want to go through both. I don't know. We should go that way.
You wouldn't be getting mind controlled?
Well, no. It might not be like it would be the factory, but it doesn't mean we're gonna do it.
No, I'm sorry. Please let me out.
Hey, this gives us answers.
Hey,
right?
Professor X.
So they're controlling us.
Yeah.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens.
Oh.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
I want to find out.
So we work for a company that's trying to do world domination.
Oh, camera.
Now the monitors jump to life. Their true nature revealed.
Fired.
Each bore the number of an employee in the building. Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen. And Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place.
Where's
where
Mona?
Freedom meant nothing.
We are 427? Right there?
Employee 427. Yeah, that's my office.
Huh.
They watched me do everything in there?
I'm not surprised.
That's not good.
Okay. We'll go... Huh. So, if we're all brainwashed, why is it that I'm the only one?
Yeah, why was I not invited to this secret meeting? What does that do? It's...
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Like, they controlled him to feel happy.
It's a lie.
Sure, but it could be worse. It could be worse.
He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it.
Bro.
His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Okay. Rachel, was Truman happy? No.
For a little while.
The heart of the operation.
It's like being watched
controls labeled with emotions.
Truman Show's really good.
Or sad, or content. Walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life.
Yeah.
For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
I was gonna say, if there's a number five, then maybe we should hit 1 through 5.
Yeah.
Or however many.
I'd rather be open with my eyes and then be...
Oh, Stanley.
What do you mean?
You didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control? Oh, Stanley. I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do.
No, turn it off. Sorry.
You were supposed to let it go. Turn the controls off and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification,
you don't have to.
Detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex. How long until detonation then? Let's say, 2 minutes.
I'm sorry, girl.
Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley?
What is
it's
it?
It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it.
Okay.
Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one
Whoa.
Of us. More time to talk about you.
Oh, this is that's
me.
What I'm telling you.
Oh, flip. I'm not having enough time.
What all this means, I barely know where to
start.
Okay, so... Okay, I can do this.
What's that?
Maybe.
You'd like to know where your co-workers are.
Five.
A moment of solace before you're obliterated. All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free.
Oh?
Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone.
There's
other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside.
What are you trying to do
or I
right
let
now?
It burn
I don't
to
know.
A crisp.
Well, why don't you start with 1 and 2?
This motion of events has been rather amusing. Watching
going
you
backwards?
Try to make sense of everything
know.
And take back the control wrested away from
45
you.
45 seconds.
Quite
okay, rich. I got this.
I almost hate to see it
One,
go.
Two.
But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left.
That's five.
But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with
three.
It.
Oh,
okay.
I'm going to put
and then
some
go up the
extra
stairs
time
and then back
the
to
clock.
Five.
Why not?
Okay.
These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees.
So he released the other.
Oh dear me! What's the
but
matter,
why
Stanley?
Did he get it?
Is it that you
later?
Have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be
or,
doing right now?
Okay.
Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button,
that's not it.
Screen to screen,
that's not it.
Clicking on every little thing in this room.
Shut up, man.
You don't
these
know.
Numbered buttons. No, these colored ones. Or maybe this big red button. Or this door.
Bro, this is like
everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video
no,
game can be beaten?
Do you hear him? He's so, the way he talks
is
so bizarre.
Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is?
Incorrect.
Stanley.
So, is he the bad guy?
You're in for quite a disappointment.
Yeah.
But here's a spoiler for you.
There's buttons on.
That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless. To see you made humble.
It's hard to figure out because
this is
you're
not a challenge.
So much, and I don't
it's
have
a tragedy. You wanted
four.
To control this world, that's fine.
Oh.
But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't. Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have
shut
left
up.
To struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here.
We're
just
so dead.
You being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life?
I can do this.
I wonder if we're not supposed to figure it out.
Make it count.
Like, we're not supposed to.
It's all the same to me.
I
all
just
a part
wonder
of
if we're
joke.
Not supposed to do anything.
And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life
bro.
From the moment we fade in until the moment I say, happily erupt.
We died.
Mm-hmm.
So he's God?
No.
Or is it like me writing a story? I'm just cruel to...
Damn.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
The wrong way. Because you would think that turning
Stanley
it off would
decided
be
to
going
go up
against
to his
the grain.
Bosses.
But
coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Whoa. He went downstairs.
But Stanley just
couldn't
do it.
It.
He considered the possibility of facing his
I
boss.
I like that there's still a lot of options
admitting he had left
where
his post
go.
During work hours. He
like
might
the
be
escape
fired
route
for that.
And...
And in such a competitive economy,
other
why
stuff.
Had he taken that risk? All because
this
he believed
crazy,
everyone had vanished. His
we
boss would think he was crazy.
To beat the narrator.
And then something occurred
yeah.
to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe I am crazy. All of my co-workers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment for no reason at all. None of it made any logical sense. And as Stanley pondered this, he began to make other strange observations. For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down? Why did doors close automatically behind him wherever he went? And for that matter, these rooms were starting
to
look
familiar.
Were they simply repeated?
I know this might sound stupid.
No,
can Stanley we do anything
himself,
with that?
This is
no.
all too
okay.
strange. This can't be real.
Okay.
And at
that's
last,
fine.
He came to the conclusion that had
no.
been on the tip of his tongue. He
just
hadn't found
just
the
thinking.
Words for it. I'm dreaming! He yelled. This is all a dream.
Oh.
What a relief Stanley felt
yeah,
to have finally found
yeah.
an answer, an explanation.
So B12 is
his co-workers
here.
Weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all. And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons.
Bro.
I may as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid.
So
he imagined
much.
Himself flying and began to gently float above the
I
ground.
I like to critically
then
think.
He imagined himself soaring through space on a magical star field. And it too appeared.
Whoa.
It was so much fun.
This is freaky.
And Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up.
He's taking
how
control of the
story.
How was
he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing
he
and thinking?
Yes, it's kind
now
of
now the voice was
whoa,
describing itself being considered
before?
By Stanley, who found it particularly
Kevin
strange.
Moved. It changed.
I'm dreaming about
look.
A voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought.
There's gotta be something I can
and
do.
And while he thought it all very odd, and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not a dream. How could
way
it be?
Out.
Was Stanley simply deceiving himself? believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself.
When you click on it, or is that just glitching?
Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life. Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite a shock to Stanley. After all, he knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was in fact a dream. Did the voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a moment ago? How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too. Surely, if he could just... He would prove it. He would prove that he was in control, that this was a dream. So he closed his eyes gently, and he invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin, the press of the mattress on his back, the fresh air of a world outside this one. Let me wake up, he thought to himself. I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over. Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing the buttons. Please, it's all I want. I want my apartment and my wife and my job.
Oh, he's married.
All I want is my life exactly the way it's always been. My life is normal.
Excuse me.
I am normal.
You're not normal.
Everything will be fine.
I hate my wife. I want out of this life.
I am okay.
I'm okay. I wake up saying the same thing.
Well, we're back in the same room.
Yeah, so nothing really changed.
Stanley began screaming.
What?
Please, someone, wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who am I? And everything went black.
I guess that's just what happens when you go to get screened, but there can't be, it's not every single option, right?
This is the story of a woman named
Mariella.
It's like
a maze, right? We have to find the right direction.
Something else is different.
Mariella woke up on a day like any other.
We're playing someone else now.
She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk.
Oh, we died.
And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy. This much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal. I am sane. I am in control of my mind.
She finds peace in his life.
I know what is real and what isn't. It was comforting to think this, and in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day. The very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career, and by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this.
I don't know. This is
so
weird.
It was only a moment that she stood
the whole
there,
game,
staring
the
down at the body.
We just have to find the right route. So every time, I don't know.
Literally, we make every choice, and we'll be stuck in a room.
Yeah, so I'm thinking... See, the tricky thing is, like, trying to figure out which rooms to go to, because...
So I went downstairs to go to the office.
Yeah.
We took a right, and it immediately restarted us.
Really?
Yeah, remember, I went to the right doorway.
Vaguely.
And popped us back in the room.
Okay, so, yeah, okay, let's take that as an example. So we know we can start with left every time, and then we see what option we, from there on, what we need to take. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, I guess we just gotta keep trying the different options to figure out how we get free.
Oh, gosh.
Huh.
Well, this will be a good stopping point for now. I'm sure we're gonna have many, many different... parts of this, because we're going to suck at this game. But I hope you guys enjoyed this as much as we did.
Mm-hmm.
Even though it's super confusing and difficult. The guy talks a lot.
He does talk a lot.
I can't even hear myself.
Sometimes I want him to just stop for a little bit.
Because I can't hear myself think sometimes.
And the way you're just clicking everything, I'm like, gosh, you're driving me insane.
I know, I'm like panicking, because he's like, da 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 da
da da da da da da. Yeah...
Anyways, guys, I'm Gavin.
And I'm Rachel.
And we're the Dorky Doo. We'll see you in the next one.